When our civilization is confronted with something we can't explain, and when an overwhelming portion of the population demands an answer to the enigma, then what we have been left with in the past is guesswork based on the understanding of a certain era. We are trying to answer questions without considering the global lost civilization that no doubt existed before the most ancient civilizations that we know about. Nowhere does it say that primitive man was advanced in construction marvels like the Great Pyramid. The dynastic Egyptians, for example, were a proud civilization. They documented their history in relief carvings and in hieroglyphics that are literally on every monument dating to the dynastic period of Egypt, yet there is nothing about the Great Pyramid. No reference that they constructed it, no detail at all exists about this thing, and you have to ask why. If the dynastic Egyptians built the Great Pyramid, then why did they not document it or even boast pride about the achievement? The fact must be that this thing was already present here as the dynastic period emerged. The reason we are told they did construct it is so we don't question the true origins of our civilization, which, by the way, we have no real idea about either. The Paleo-Sanskrit inscriptions at the Great Pyramid are telling us something important, but what is it that these textual messages are signaling? Wait, to hear this. It almost looks like an alien inscription, and for all we know, it very well may be. These strange inscriptions on this epic marvel are intriguing to us because they appear to mean something that could be within our grasp of understanding, and indeed, these four letters could be a symbol as to how the pyramid would have worked. Consider the following. Advanced explanations of the divine cyclical influence of various planets on human consciousness cannot be properly understood without an advanced knowledge of the physics of infrasound standing waves and the function of the Great Pyramid. Complete knowledge of the physics of acoustic resonance required for the comprehension of ancient texts was still possessed by the many learned kings of descendant cultures, as exemplified by the claim of Assyrian king Ashurbanipal inscribed on clay tablets. I understand the enigmatic writings of the stone tablets from before the deluge. Modern scientific evidence for the deluge suggests that in the form of multiple meteorite impacts, approximately 12,800 years ago, causing a critical overload of the global pyramid network and thereby lowering the entire electromagnetic field of Earth and generating torrential downpours worldwide that raised sea levels drastically and began the era known as Holocene. The deluge has also been linked with the global distribution of impact spherules resulting from meteoric bombardment. Paleo-Sanskrit texts from this remote era reflect the heavy laments of a culture in disillusion due to diminished state of granting from the deities. Now understood as referencing the measurable reduction of infrasound resonance of the planets of our solar system after the meteoric catastrophe, the intensity level of the planet's infrasonic gravity field not only influences fundamental biorhythms and thus the consciousness of all living beings on the planet, but this field even determines the quantum fixation of atomic decay properties of all the atoms comprising the planet and all its life forms. Casing stones stripped from the faces of the Giza pyramids attest to the destruction wave action that once reached a height of 178 meters above the current sea level. This surprising fact is further reinforced by the presence of quite noticeable and well-documented layers of seashells deposited up to great heights on the pyramids and indeed throughout the entire Giza plateau. The mysterious four symbols are dismissed as graffiti by archaeologists, but nonetheless, the advanced meaning of these four symbols may be the key to understanding this thing. For even if this is graffiti, it may be graffiti that is dating to the time of the pyramid builders, and in this sense, it is the oldest and only inscription that exists that we know about. So, what does it mean? Well, get this. Simplicity is the ultimate sophistication, and this is a signature of the builders of the pyramid. Their intelligence being superior to ours, they had realized that these four signs engraved on a granite plaque and cut to perfection would undergo the onslaught of vandalism, pillage, and censorship in our time, while a simple graffiti, innocuous, incomprehensible, and imperceptible, would go unnoticed. This discretion stands the test of time. They stand for angle, equator, three bodies of water, and longitude. The value of the angles correspond exactly to that of the axis of rotation of our planet. Planets vibrate at particular frequencies. That their bodies are tuned to a different frequency may account for why extraterrestrial visitors have a different time or find it impossible to maintain a visible presence on Earth. Tones sent through a pair of stone cones from base to apex appear to create a phase displacement or frequency multiplication factor, or both. Drawings on an Egyptian wall depict an object like a stone tuning fork, about 8 feet high with one prong longer than the other, likely used to divide a stream of sound energy, creating a lag or phase difference. Recent research reveals that sound waves have a slightly magnetic quality. However, this magnetism might be the result of vibrating material and not a product of the sound itself. The fundamental beat of our planet is 8 Hertz, otherwise known as the Schumann resonance, that is named after physicist Winfried Otto Schumann, who documented it mathematically in 1952. Have you ever considered that at this entrance to the ancient marvel, there appears to be a seat, a throne perhaps? We are not saying this is exactly what this is, but it is resembling something for being seated on. Remember that this is the only part of the wonder that has the lighter brickwork stripped away, and we have these glyphs along with a throne, an entryway with massive great weight-bearing stones for support. Consider that if we have this here, then perhaps the entire underjacket of this thing may have further clues as to its purpose. We will leave it at that for the moment, guys. You can let us know what you think these ancient glyphs are referencing. Comment below, and as always, thank you for watching.